No, Miss Muffet's paws need to go back, otherwise she's in the foundation.
Good morning. It's early. I thought, let's get ready. Welcome to my channel. If you are new, my name is Nikki. I'm 44, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And as I said, I'm getting ready. I have a new cutesy top with sleeves. It's so cute. But I also have a primer, and I actually got these from Black Moon Cosmetics, 3 lippies. It's Betty Jean's fault. She swatched this one, which is called Cider, and I know it's one of her favorites, but it is only available around Halloween-y times. It's available now. It's very pretty. Go get it. And I got the green one called Hazel, and I got a shade called Grim. I have worn... I think Grim I tried. No, I tried Cider. It's a very nice formula. But I really want to use these today. I actually want to use this one. But maybe I will use this one. So, hence the fact that I grabbed this palette as well. The W7 on the rocks. Because it's W7's dupe for the subculture. And I thought let's kind of play with that then today as well. And see how that is. The brush, how does the... Oh no, don't dig your nail in. The brush feels... Well, the brush does not feel that bad, actually. I also yesterday picked up the Angel Veil Primer from NYX. I don't know why, but I thought I needed it. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do. I already did my brows. In case you're new, because otherwise I have a naked butt face. So let's start with priming the face. Feels lighter than a cloud and leaves skin looking and feeling divine. Or shall I start with eyes? Let's start with eyes. Because I can. Let's get my primer. I'm going to use the ABH primer because that is my primer of choice. Especially with something, I don't know, new. I have heard people talking about this palette. And I know that it existed. But I could get it from, I think the UK had it. I have seen it on Boozy Shop, but it wasn't there anymore. And then it came to store here and I was like... I know that the subculture isn't available for a lot of people anymore. I think it's only available on the UK site from ABH. And for the rest, I don't know, it's gone. So I think it's what I understood, it's going to be discontinued. Which is actually a shame because it's a really, really nice color story. And I think the quality is really, really good. So yeah. So I had actually thought because the one that I have... I received as a gift, and it is an older one. It's one of the first batches, so I thought maybe I will get then a newer one, you know. But if this one is close enough, I don't really need to. And I know that a lot of you really like this color story, and I think that this one is better accessible, foremost, that is. If you live in the Netherlands, I got it at Kruidvat. They sell all the ABH dupes in store. That when I got the one from ABH... Let me grab it so I can show it to you side by side. Oh, I forgot to put on my lighties. Let me do that too. Okay, now I'm feeling fancy. So here I have the subculture. I'm kind of looking at it color-wise. There is not that much of a difference. I think that they came very, very close. So here they are. The top one is the ABH. I hope you can kind of see. There is not a lot of difference, people. But yeah, I am going to play with the yellows and the... Yes, with the yellows and such. I'm going to start with the shade called Piña Colada. And let me swatch it against the shade Edge, because I'm actually quite curious. Piña Colada is here. That's W7. This is ABH. Yeah, okay. So I can see a color difference, because the one from ABH, I hope you can see. The one from ABH, I don't know if you can see. It's a little bit more orange. It's a little bit more deep. So that's the difference. So I'm grabbing the shade called Piña Colada. It's pretty powdery from W7. I'm going to tap it on my eye. Now, theoretically, I could do one eye, one palette, and the other eye, the other palette. But I also have to go to work. Well, my outside of the housework, and I kind of Yeah, I kind of don't want to. I kind of want to have a uniform look today, if I am able to. It does blend out very, very easily though. On a tacky base. Oh. Cool. I actually want to go to, do we want to go to the shade New Wave? No, not really. I want to go to the greens, I think. Next, I think I'm going to go to Magnum, which is the shade Untamed in the ABH. I will swatch them side by side. If the video isn't too long, I will put it on the at the end, or maybe I will just put pictures on the end of the palette side by side. I'm going to grab this one next, which is called Magnum, and in ABH it's called Untamed. And this is going to go on the outer corner. Ooh, and the crease, wow. Now this is the first time that I'm trying W7's eyeshadow formula. Have I ever tried anything from W7? I don't think so. Maybe I have, but I cannot remember. So this is the very first time I'm trying their eyeshadow formula, and I really like it so far. Now I can see a depth difference from this palette and the ABH, and you know, it should, there should be a difference. There also, there actually should be I cannot think of the word, but basically ABH's formula should be better. Quality, that's what I wanted to say. Because this palette retailed for, what was it, 10? No, less. I think it was 7 or 8 euros. The Subculture is almost, what is it, almost 50, I think. So it's a lot more expensive, and the ABH formula should be better. But I have found that a lot of the time, especially the mainstream brands, are more expensive, but not better. Okay, back to the first brush and a little bit of the first color. I'm going to grab a smaller brush and the shade called Caracao, I think this one, the darkest one, which is Axis in the ABH. I just want to, I don't know, darken up the outer corner and the crease a little. Oh, I almost forgot Miss Muffet, because we are officially in fall. So yeah. Spider time has been here for quite some time where I live. I always, every year, my house is surrounded by spiders. They are the, do you call them the pinwheel spiders? We call them cross spiders because it's like him. He has a cross on his back, you know, and usually when they made a web, they stay put. So it's not like they wander about your house. So yeah, and they're always everywhere. So when I go and leave my door, my house, I need to do like that in the air, so to make sure that one of the spiders didn't make a web there. Usually they do twice or something, and then I don't destroy a web, or not on purpose anyway. Usually I just unhook two threads and then flip it over, you know. But I do know it takes a lot of energy for a spider to make a web, and they also learn, so if you do that twice, they won't make it on the same spot again, or at least not that spider. So I actually let them be where they want to be, except if they are in the walking, in the walk, you know? So that's basically then when I remove the web, and for the rest, they are free to do whatever the hell they want. I don't know, spiders for me are almost, I don't know, I feel like they protect. You know, does that make any sense? Am I alone in that? And it is not specifically the spider, but the web. It's almost like they make kind of a protective screen against negative energy, you know, that kind of thing. So yeah, I don't want them to walk over me if I can help it, but yeah. Okay. Yes, I think it is time for Shimmer. Let's see. Don't want this one. Oh, the shimmers, they swatch a little bit thin. Oh, they swatch very thin. I kind of want to use this one, but let's see what we can do with the glitter primer, because I feel like I really need a glitter primer with this shade. Okay, let's grab my NYX primer. Anyway, I'm just placing the primer on my eye, and I kind of want to be a little bit precise. Okay, then I'm going to go to the shade called Champagne Toast, which is this one. And I love the shade Electric from the ABH palette, so let's see what happens. Okay, so fortunately I do pick up quite a bit. Okay, so yeah, it's almost, I don't know, it is a little bit lackluster, this one. Especially compared to the one from ABH. I'm going to put a little bit of I want to say blue, but that's not it. Green. Oh, let's grab another green. Let's grab the shade Martini Olive, this one. I was saying, I love the shade Electric from the ABH palette, and this one is a little bit more your old-fashioned shimmer, you know? And I don't mind that. I don't mind old-fashioned shimmers at all. But it is not as nice and intensely vibrant, what am I doing now? I don't know, as the one from the ABH palette. For comparison, let me grab it on the other side of that brush and just put it on top so you can see. Can I pick anything up? It's hard pan. Really? It has a little bit more of a shift in it. And it is a little bit more intense as well, the one from ABH. Okay, so there we are there now. What do I want for the... Oh, I also have a lot of fallout. But fortunately, I haven't done anything yet, so I can easily clean that up, I hope. What do I want with the bottom lid? I don't know. I don't know. Let me do everything there too, though. So, basically my thoughts so far on this palette is that I think that the mattes perform beautifully. I do feel that the ones from ABH have more richness and depth in the color, which it should. And yeah, looking at the shimmers in this palette, yeah... You know, I can hear a lot of people say, for the price it's good, but you know what? There are palettes that are the same pricing, but have better shimmers. For instance, the ones from Catrice that I have, the cardboard palettes, they are a few euros more expensive. They are 10, but they do have a very, very good quality in the shimmers. I'm just going to put a little bit of the ABH on top here as well. So if you want to get a similar vibe, you can definitely use this palette. Definitely. It's just that the shimmers are, at least this one that I used, is a little bit thinner. It's a little bit more your traditional old school shimmer. Not foiled, just shimmer and shiny. It's a nice pretty color, but it is not as intense as I like shimmers to be sometimes. That's okay. Now that I know that, I can kind of take that into consideration, you know? Okay, let's kind of do the face. Let's grab the primer. So the Angel Veal Primer. I'm curious. They also had the Honey Do Me Primer. Oh yeah, and I got this, if you live in the Netherlands, at Ethos. Because Ethos is also selling NYX now, which is, well, kind of weird. But yeah, so, maybe I should have shook it. It's like this, white. Let's see. Oh, this feels very silicony. And almost oily. So I think that if I were to use, I have my more fatty sunscreen underneath today. I think that if you have an oily skin, you won't like this. I think that if you have a dry skin, you will. Just feeling on how it goes on my face. I don't really know if I am particularly fond of it just yet. Let's let it sit for just a while. I kind of feel like it is a little bit settling in now. I don't know if it is doing anything, to be quite honest with you. But let me use my Catrice HD Coverage Foundation. I'm just going to whack that on with a sponge.
No, Miss Muffet's paws need to go back, otherwise she's in the foundation.
So I'm my foundation and concealer is on and I'm basically just cream contouring a little bit. But I was doing this off camera and I was like, wasn't I doing a get ready with me? Isn't that supposed to be kind of chatty a little bit more or something like that? So I thought, let's turn the camera back on. Let's kind of chat about why my lighting is so different lately. The reason I am, I kind of changed up my lighting a little bit because I'm constantly trying to showcase everything as accurately as possible, at least color wise. So yeah, but also I don't like it if my if it is too orange. I don't like it if it is too pink, you know. It's kind of a fine balance, but I cannot really accurately see how the color comes out. I can see on my viewfinder, I can see something, but my viewfinder is yay big, you know. I have a computer screen here, but that computer is old and it doesn't depict the shade as accurately as my computer downstairs does. So that is why I am finicking with the lighting right now. And you know what, maybe I just need to stop effing around with it and just put it on auto, because maybe that's it. But you know, the reason that I took it off of auto is because if I hold something up to the camera and I have it on auto, the rest goes black, you know, and I kind of find that annoying. So yeah, that's the, and then basically with whatever I am wearing, I think the white balance shifts and I don't really like that. But yeah, we will see how this looks now. Okay, cream contouring is on. Let's kind of give a little bit of bronzing going on with the bronzing stick. And I just do this. And this is also how I do my cream contour. Although my cream contour is pretty light. It's a stiffer formula. So I can just put it on the brush and then blend it or stipple it on top of my cheeks. Or underneath, not on top. Because you don't want to contour there, or at least I don't. Maybe you do, I don't know. So yeah, my thoughts, a little bit more thoughts on the W7 palette. I think that if you like the subculture, but I don't know, cannot get a hold of it, or don't want to pay the full price, because it's just ridiculous that it is still available, at least here in Europe, for full price. I don't, you know. I think this is definitely a contender. Is it as good? It kind of depends on what you want. Well, when I was putting on my foundation, I noticed that the green was a little bit too low, so I brought it up a little bit more, and I accidentally dipped into the Subculture palette, because that's here in front of me as well. The pigmentation is way, way more. So if you are, if you don't like that, if you don't like, you dip your brush in and you have instant pigmentation, which I I understand if you do not like that, then the W7 is definitely worth it, because the W7, while it still has its pigmentation, it is more buildable than immediate. Basically, how I would compare them is the Subculture I would compare to a lot of indie brands, you know, the stiffer formulas but more pigmentation, so it's a little bit more of a learning curve to work with, and the W7 is more your standard mainstream formula. Is it bad? By no means, but I would not pay 50 euros for a formula like this, just saying. But it is a very nice formula. So there's that. Okay, let's do... Do I want a cream blush? I don't know. I kind of want something a little bit orangey. I have that in Tiger Lily, so let's grab Tiger Lily. Okay, a little bit on the back of the hand, then the brush. And I just do that. Okay, see what I'm doing now. So, and stipple it on. So yeah, there's that. What is going on? Well, basically it is fall. That's what I kind of wanted to... That's what I was going... talking about, right? Oh no. I hear my floor creaking. Usually that means that something or someone is coming into the room. But then again, we are closer to Halloween, so you never know. Here, at least. You know? Oh, it's a... Really? Hi, DJ. It's the kitty cat. He almost gave me a heart attack. Silly kitty. It's the tarot cat. He's inside. Inside the room. So, the postman came with stuff. So let's unbox it. Because it's merch. Ooh. Let's see what we have here. Ooh, we have a hoodie. Why are you stuck? Really? Thank you. Nice. Oh, but of course it is covered in glitter. Why? Because I am covered in glitter. Yay! Oh, nice. So, we have the first thing I'm going to show you, the hoodie. Can you see it? It's a vest, basically, with nestlings on the front. And then this is the back. And this is a medium, I believe. Oh, small. It's probably pretty big. Let's see. Can I zoom out even more? Yeah, I can. So let's put it on. Okay. So it is good for me. And as I said, I have a small now. So cool this. And it has pockets, so it's fit to size. So my size is basically a
triple XL.
No, look, we have the merch.
We have merch?
Yes, it just came in. Is this mine? Oh yeah, they're mine. God damn it. Aw.
Wow.
But they are. So yours are still in the mail.
I feel pretty good though.
Yeah, this is the vest, so it's accurate to size because this is a small.
Yeah. Nice.
Yes. I have poofy sleeves.
Oh, yeah,
let's see if I can fit the sweater on too, which is a medium then, I think.
Huh?
Also a small. I thought I was a medium. What did I order for you? Did I order...
I don't feel like you ordered me L.
Okay.
I don't fit S or M. I need to pee with you then.
Then go pee. Oh no, I think I have makeup on. My sweater. Okay, so the hoodie is also small. I would have preferred this one to be a little bit bigger because I like my hoodies a little bit bigger, but it does fit. So if you are interested in my merch, the link is down in the description box, and this time it works. It is true to size. So basically my shirt size is a 36 or... what is that? Extra small. Sometimes the shirt I have underneath this is actually an extra small from Primark. So yeah, but it is very, very cool. So let me see if I can... this is a little bit better. Also, I have a big booby bra on today. Just saying. So yeah, that was the merch. So yeah, it's all listed down in the description box. or not, the link to the merch is down in the description box. That was what I wanted to say. Okay. I was talking about something and I don't know what. Let's kind of finish off the face. Do I want powder? Sure. I'm just going to powder the face with the Revolution setting powder because I have it here and I'm too lazy to go and find anything else. Oh, I forgot freckles. Of course I do. Doesn't matter. Okay, face is set. Do I want bronzer? Sure. Let's get the Kiko Milano bronzer because I have it here. That's the reason. I have it here and I'm lazy. What do I want to do with the bottom of my... I think this is bronze enough. I don't want to over-bronze today. Let's grab the Milani Luminoso. Cutesy. Okay, let's put on some freckles. Let me get my lime crayon pen. Because that one is a lot quicker than the freck. I'm grabbing the darker one from ColourPop to enhance some of my own darker ones. And to just add some darker ones here and there. Something like that today. Okay. I need to do the bottom, yes. What do I want with the bottom? I can grab Maraschino Cherry. Maybe that will be fun. So, Maraschino Cherry is this one. And I'm really going to look down so I don't get everything on my face. This is a shade Tasty Aubergine from Catrice. It's actually a lip pencil, but it doesn't matter. I use it as an eye pencil. Yes, which is not red, but well, basically aubergine. It's going to go a little bit lower as well. And then I'm grabbing the shade I just used and kind of buff it over a little bit to hopefully get it to blend together. I can do the shade Champagne Toast, but I just don't think that it will show up. But we can. Let's see. So let's spray it. So I'm grabbing a little bit. Well, I'm grabbing a lot on a brush and then I'm going to spray. Let's see what it does. It's cute. It's cute. However, I want a little bit of something extra. That's better. This is Ofra Blissful. Ah. No, Star Island. That's what I put in the inner corner. Okay, that's cool. And now though, it's time for basically falsies and the lippy. So I think I kind of want this one cider. That was the one that I had in mind that I wanted to use today. So let me put that one on. Put on also falsies. And then I will show you the completed look. Otherwise the video will be 15 hours long. 15, yes. That's Dutch. All complete. Here is the finished look. That was weird, yes. This was what I wanted to do today. Well, kinda. So yeah. I did decide on the shade Cider, which I just think is gorgeous. It's just a unique shade. I'm very, very happy that I picked this one up. And I'm also happy that I picked up the other ones. Now, the formula is very nice. It is. It reminded me a little bit of the L'Oreal Rouge Signature line. The ones from L'Oreal are maybe a little bit thinner of a formula. But this is almost the same. And it is very opaque. I just basically need one dip. And then I can do my lips. And it dries down completely matte. Yeah. I like it a lot. I kind of gave you thoughts on the palette already, didn't I? Yeah, basically, if you like the color story, I think it is a very nice dupe for the Subculture palette. Swatch them side by side and show you the pictures now.
The top part is the W7 and the bottom is the ABH. And as you can see, there is so much difference in vibrancy and depth. The ABH was basically one swipe and then you get this. And the W7, I do have to build up in certain areas to get it to show up, so they don't swatch the best. However, they do perform very, very nicely with a brush. It is just that, yeah, the ABH formula is, as you can see, a lot richer and deeper in color, and some of the colors are just a tad more vibrant and maybe a different tone. But overall, especially on the eyes, they do perform similarly. Honestly, I do prefer the ABH one. But if you cannot get a hold of the ABH one, the W7 one is a very, very nice alternative. So here they are. This is the color difference, so not a lot of difference in the palettes themselves. But when you compare the swatches, you definitely see a color difference.
But yeah, as I suspected, the Subculture palette just has more depth in the shades. More pigmentation right off the bat. And it kind of shoots because of the huge price difference. But I do think that the W7 one is a very good dupe. And I am actually happy that I picked it up. The only downside is that I think especially the shade Champagne Toast that I used here is very thin. And I think that the shade Sugar Rim, well, that's a little bit better, actually. I don't know, the shade Champagne Trust, it's just so lackluster. And then the other shimmer that's in here is better. So yeah, this is kind of a dud, which is kind of a shame, because I do really like the shade. It works, but it is not as nice and vibrant as I would have liked to be to complement this palette. And that's it. So yeah, that's then basically the only kind of duddish shade in the palette, which is not that bad. I think that is going to be it for today's video. Oh yeah, the primer. It does feel nice, but the funny thing is that the foundation that I have on is a little bit more mattifying and it gave a luminous finish, which I did not really think would happen with this primer. I thought it would blur a little bit more. I do think that it blurs a little bit. But yeah, I think that's it. I'm going to keep on playing around with it. And that is going to be it for today's video, I think. The makeup I use will be listed down in the description box as well. Let me know if you have any of these. Let me know if this was helpful. Maybe you saw the palette but did not really know if it was worth your time and energy to pick up. I think it is. If you like the color story, you really want Subculture but don't want to get it or cannot get it, I think this is a very nice alternative. So yeah, thank you so much for watching today's video. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to check out my subscription box for the link to join the channel to become a member, for my merch, my social media, discount codes, products. There's a lot of information down there. Go check it out. And I will leave my Get Ready With Me playlist on the end screen for you to check out as well. And also check out the rest of the cards, the eye cards that are strewn about in this video. I think that's it. Yes, thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one.